everybody. This video presents the results of the model checking contest. It is a competition between model checking tools dealing with asynchronous parallelism. Asynchronous parallelism is an extremely large source of complexity. We must deal with it since nowadays numerous systems, possibly life-critical, involving many participants, computerized or not, must reach a common goal without failure. A model checking tool explores all the configurations of a complex system in order to check its properties. I will detail this later. Various sources estimate the total number of fundamental particles in the observable universe to be within the range of 10 to the power of 80 to 10 to the power of 85. These are small objects compared to the number of configurations the competing tools may have to deal within the model checking contest. So, I'm glad to let you know how competing tools in 2021 were able to cope with very large complex systems. All results will soon be published on the model checking contest website, where you can already have a look on the past edition of this event, mcc.lip6.fr. This year, we celebrate the 11th edition of the model checking contest. This event was created in 2011 aside the PageNet conference with two main goals in mind. The first goal is to promote the development of experimental model checking tools to experiment theoretical issues and their practicability for real-world problems. This is also a way to enforce technological transfer by enabling the existence of robust tools. I will explain a bit more this point in my concluding remarks. The second objective is to progressively elaborate a common collection of models to serve as a benchmark for the community. This is important to let researchers compare the efficiency of new theoretical results and algorithms on a common and sound basis. Basically, a participating model checking tool must process examinations on models and provide results that are analyzed. I will detail these two terms very soon. So far, the model checking contest is handled by six researchers spread in several cities of France. Pierre Bouvier and Hubert Garavel from INRIA Grenoble and Laure Messon-Hila from Université de Nanterre are handling and maintaining models to be processed. Loïc Jezekel from Université de Nantes and Emmanuel Paviouadé from Université de Paris are dealing with the formulas which are regenerated every year for some of the examination tools have to deal with. They also produce smarter formulas every year. Finally, Francis Hulaibar and myself are handling the execution of tools, collection of outputs, and the automated analysis of produced data. Models are provided by the entire community. This ensures a large variety. Diverse application domains and modeling techniques are represented, thus providing some neutrality to this benchmark. As an input format, we use PageNet, which are suitable for representing concurrent systems. Moreover, there exists an ISO standard to represent PageNet, called PNML. This is the input format we provide in our benchmark. Year after year, our model database is growing and now contains 114 different specifications. Many of them are parameterized and can be declined into several instances having various complexities. In 2021, each tool was confronted to 1,411 variants of these 114 models. We call variants of a given model Instances are a good way to observe how tool can cope with an increasing complexity of a given parameterized model. As I told you, new models are added every year. We call these surprise models because no tool was confronted to these models before. Thus, no strategy could have been elaborated for the situation they can raise. Other models are called known since they were introduced in past years. Of course, surprise models bring higher scores than known ones. In 2021, a total of 11 models were introduced for a total of 182 instances. Let us thank Elvio Amparore, Hugues Evrard, Nick Feng, Hubert Gravel, Lina Marzo, Rosa Mendes, Tramine Nguyen, Lucas Salvador, Tanner Sorensen, Antoine Toulalan and Karsten Wolf for providing us with these nice models. You will find information about our benchmark in the model section of our website, ncc.lip6.fr. Each participating tool has to deal with examinations on each model instance. An examination is basically a question. We have six families of examinations corresponding to functions one can expect from a model checking tool. The first family groups only one examination, state space. Participating tools must explore the full state space of the model system, all its configurations, and provide data about its size. The second family, global properties, gathers five examinations. Reachability deadlock, quasi-liveness, stable marking, liveness, and one-safe. These correspond to structural information about the state space. The third family, upper bound, also contains one examination. The goal is to compute the maximum number of tokens in a PetriNet place for a subset of places selected in the specification. The fourth family, reachability formula, deals with the evaluation of logic formulas applied to the state space. Such formulas may refer to states or to transitions, so this family gathers two examinations, reachability cardinality and reachability favorability. The fifth family corresponds to causal formula expressed using computational tree logic, CTL. As for reachability, atomic propositions refer to states or to transitions, so two examinations are considered, CTL cardinality and CTL favorability. Finally, the last family corresponds to causal formulas expressed using linear temporal logic, LTL. It also groups two examinations, LTL cardinality and LTL favorability. The rules section in our website describes these examinations with more details. The submission kit describes precisely how tools do communicate with the execution environment and also provide a formula manual. In fact, an interesting side effect of the model checking contest is that the XML-based representation of formulas for the reachability, CTL, and LTL examinations is becoming a sort of de facto standard. This year, each tool was confronted to 13 examinations on the 1,411 model instances. So, each tool was invoked more than 18,500 times. For each execution, a tool may report it does not compete or display results in a predefined format so that extraction and analysis are performed automatically. Over the years, a total of 28 tools have participated in the 11 editions of the model checking contest, and several of them to almost all the editions. It may be a challenge to beat these tools which are not quite optimized. This year, we got 7 participants. This is less than in past years, but considering the problem raised by 2 years in a row of COVID situation, especially in universities, it's a good score. So, here are the participants for the 2021 edition. EdPack is coming from China and is an open source software package dedicated to complex distributed or embedded systems. This tool is mainly used for LTL model checking. Gretespe and Medley is coming from Italy and deals with both qualitative analysis, which is evaluated here, and quantitative analysis. It offers a large variety of features. It participates in all examinations of the model checking contest. ITS tool is coming from France and supports a large variety of backend engines, symbolic, SAT-based, etc., etc. This year, an optimization engine has been developed to increase the global efficiency of the tool. It participates in all the 13 examinations of the model checking contest. Lola is a well-known tool in this community, which is regularly on the podium. Lola was in refactoring last year and is coming back in 2021. Lola participates in all examinations but state space. SMPT is a new tool coming from France. It is an SMT-based model checker dealing with reachability properties on generalized and unbounded PetriNets. It includes an adaptation of two main procedures, bounded model checking, BMC, and property-directed reachability, PDR, that can take advantage of a novel abstraction technique built on structural reductions. TAPAL is coming from Denmark and is a tool suite for verification of PetriNets and several extensions not experimented in the model checking context. TAPAL participates in all the examinations and, for the first time this year, in LTL1s. Finally, TINATED is coming from France. It participates in state space only. About 2 years ago, an innovative way to compute data about the state space by exploiting abstract states was introduced. I must mention two special tools. The first one is called 2020 Gold. It is a hybrid made of the gold medal of last year for each examination. It is a way to see how the state of the art has improved since the previous edition of the model checking contest. The second one is called BVT for Best Virtual Tool and computes the union of all the values computed by all tools together. Its results were thus inferred from the results of all tools, including 2020 Gold. It helps you to evaluate the complementarity of tools. When the 2021 Gold medal is close to BVT for a given examination, it means that strategies operated in other tools capture results already captured by the techniques implemented in the winning tool. Otherwise, association of tools or techniques could be investigated. As mentioned before, each tool is invoked about 18,500 times within a time confinement of 1 hour or 30 minutes for global properties examination and a memory confinement of 60 gigabytes. Second shell tools are allocated one physical core, while parallel tools are allocated 4 physical cores. BenchKit, a dedicated framework created in 2014 and enhanced every year, is used to operate these executions and collect all the results from tool and data execution from virtual machine. To operate tools for the model checking contest, we need large computers. Hopefully, there is a network of colleagues who help us by borrowing their nice machines for an exclusive use, approximately 4 weeks a year. The first nice machine is Tajo from Rostock University. Tajo embeds 96 physical cores and contains 1.5 terabytes of memory. Then we have Octoginta 2, which is an 80 physical core with 1.5 terabytes of memory loaned by Université de Nanterre. LIP6 at Sorbonne University provided two nice machines. We used 12 nodes of TOL, each one embedding 32 physical cores and 384 gigabytes of memory. We also used up to 9 nodes of SMALL, each one having 12 physical cores and 64 gigabytes of memory. These machines were operated by top-level system engineers, Catherine Herrmann in Rostock, Fabrice Le Gondry in Nanterre, Pierre-Emmanuel Leroux and Benoît Gaillard at Sorbonne University. I would like to thank very much all these colleagues and institutions. Without their support, the model checking could not exist. Indeed, altogether, there were 146,744 invocations of the 7 plus 1, the 2020 Gold Medal, tools. This required a total amount of a bit more than 7 years of CPU. This is 15 months more than last year. All these executions, including some consolidation while discussing the outputs with developers, took about 5 weeks of time in the real world. Let us now discover together the result of this edition, as many of you are probably just waiting for. For the state space examination, 4 tools did participate. The gold medal goes to TINATED, then GreatSPN grabs the silver one, and ITS tool gets the bronze medal. They are followed by TAPAL. Let us note that the 2020,000 gold medal was TINATED and would have been ranked second. The score of BVT, Best Virtual Tool, shows that the gold medal gets almost all the values computed by all the tools together. I remind you that BVT produced the union of all the values computed by the participating tools. Let us now introduce the notion of confidence rate. it is computed within a subset of trusted values. Here, you can see that confidence rate for tools is very high. In the table, right to the percentage, you can check the number of correct values among the list of trusted values we use to compute this information. More details on how we compute the confidence rate can be found in the website at the rules section. The confidence rate is a way to estimate the confidence one can have in a tool. For the global property families of examinations, four tools did participate. The gold medal goes to ITS tool, then Lola grabs the silver one, and Tapal gets the bronze medal. They are followed by QuizSPN. Let us note that the 2020 gold medal was Tapal, it would have been ranked fourth, which means that developer put a strong effort in this examination that was introduced in its current situation last year. BBT is just a bit better than the gold medal this year. Let us note that for that examination, all tools reach a 100% confidence rate. For the upper bound examination, four tools did participate. The gold medal goes to ITS tool, then Tapal grabs the silver one, and Lola gets the bronze medal. They are followed by GridSPN. Here, the winner is very close to BVT. Let us note that for that examination, all competing tools this year reach a 100% confidence rate. For the reachability family of examinations, five tools did participate. The gold medal goes to ITS tool, then Tapal grabs the silver one, and Lola gets the bronze medal. They are followed by GridSPN and SMPT. Here, the 2020 gold medal was ITS tool and would have been ranked third. BVT is just a bit above the winner this year. Let us note that for that examination, all participant tools but SMTP reach a confidence of 100%. However, reaching more than 99% for its first participation is a good result for SMTP, which is above the 2020 gold medal. For the CTL family of examinations, four tools did participate. The gold medal goes to Tapal, then ITS tool grabs the silver one, and Lola gets the bronze medal. They are followed by QuizSPN. Let us note that the 2020 gold medal was Tapal and would have been ranked second. BVT is 15% above the winner, showing that other competitors were able to catch a number of values the winner this year was not able to compute. Let us note that for that examination, no tool reached 100% confidence rate, even if the average remained close to 100%. For the LTL family of examination, five tools did participate. The gold medal goes to Tapal for its first participation in this examination. Then ITS tool grabs the silver one, and NPAC gets the bronze medal. They are followed by Lola and GratSPN. The 2020 gold medal was ITS Lola, a hybrid made of the front end of ITS tool and the back end of Lola, and would have been out of the podium. Let us note no tool competing this year reached 100%. However, most of them are over 99%. If you have a look on this chart, which represents the average confidence rate since this metric was introduced in 2015, you may notice it globally increases. Variations may be introduced by new participants or when tools get a major upgrade. This is one evidence of the positive effect of the model checking contest on the software production of our community. Of course, aside these podiums that are stimulating for academics, you can browse the executions themselves. Numerous informations are provided on the website and can be useful for developers or scientists. For each examination, you can access a full summary providing the computed values, a correctness mask, and some flags about the results as well as the score brought by this execution. When clicking on the orange arrow, you can access the execution report and watch the traces captured during the execution. Traces may also help developers to understand and reproduce what occurred in their tool in case of trouble. You may also access to the model performance charts, showing how tools compare from a CPU usage point of view or from a memory footprint point of view. From these charts, we can see how tools cope with parameterized models when parameters have an influence on its complexity. The tool resource consumption table leads you to a series of cactus plot helping you to have a global view on the behavior of tools with regards to CPU or memory management. For each examination, you can access a comparison between tools with regards to execution time and memory footprint expressed by means of scatter plots, as you can see here. On the x-axis, performances of the competing tools are shown, and on the y-axis, those of the challenging tool. The competing tool wins against its challenger for points below the diagonal, and the challenger wins for plots above the diagonal. A color code shows when all values were computed by both tools, or when the challenger computed more or less values than the competing tool. Finally, all these images of the competing tools are available via our website, as well as the disk image of the volume containing models and the generated formulas. Remember, a new set is generated every year. Models and formulas are also available as a separate archive. You can also access to the raw data that is compiled to let us view results and also a summary file presenting the execution data and results of all participants in a CSV document. I started this presentation by reminding you the main objectives of the model checking contest. Our first goal is to promote tools to experiment model checking on real systems, possibly issued from industry or complex case studies. This goal appears to be achieved. First, the model checking contest is now a regular rendezvous for the community. It also constitutes a strong benchmark tools can deal with to track certain bugs. Typically, when a tool deals with an examination for the first time, it has a lower confidence rate, which is increased the year after. I would like to mention cross-fertilization between tools. Some main components have been shared by several tools developers. Some techniques and libraries have been exchanged or mixed with success, as for last year between ITS Tool and Lola, or the transformation of Color Petrinet library between Toulouse, Paris, and Alborg. So, the model checking contest, by giving visibility to tools and by enforcing their robustness and their technical aspects, helps to increase the credibility of technological transfer to industry. Similar situations are observed in other verification areas with other contests, such as SAT, SMT Comp, SV Comp, the Hardware Model Checking Contest, and so on. This is a good trend of our communities toward reproducible science. This is assessed by the growing numbers of references on the MCC we find in scientific papers. The second objective is also reached. The set of models are regularly used in papers and formulas since the beginning. You can use this basis to enforce tools' performance, track bugs, etc. This year, some models had a new feature that was diversely supported by tools. I know that some developers already updated their programs. All the results, charts, execution information, etc. available on our website are free to use for scientific purposes. You can refer to it using the reference I'm displaying now. Feel free to use some diagrams if you want. I would like to mention a study which has just been published in Springer International Journal on Software Tools for Technology Transfer. We tracked the data provided by 5 editions of the model checking contest from 2015 to 2019. It shows several interesting information, such as some tendencies in the way techniques are improving or being replaced by others. It shows evidence of the heavy activity of our community in designing tools which are able to cope with very industrial-like examples. Oh, one more thing. As a novelty this year, aside the numeric medals you can refer to on our website, physical medals will be distributed to the participants who reach the podium. We hope we can reproduce this for later editions of the model checking contest. Thank you for your attention. You are invited at the online meeting to take place on June 23rd, 2021 at 2 p.m. Western European time. Please bring your questions and issues so that we can have nice discussions. Have a nice day.